students. I would like to begin my session sharing with you my experience as a student of your age. While doing my BA English Literature at St. Thomas College, Thrissur, affiliated to the University of Calicut, I fell in love with writing. How did it all happen? There was an essay contest organized for the college students across Kerala by the South Indian Bank. There was no student willing to represent St. Thomas College, Thrissur for this state level competition. The head of the department, Dr. George Menacheri, requested me personally to appear for the essay contest. The topic for the essay contest was the role of non-resident Indians in India's development. By God's grace, I was the winner in the state level competition. And that was the starting point of my journey as a writer. Having got recognition as an essay writer from St. Thomas College, I was offered to participate in another competition held at national level by the Nuclear Energy Department, the Bhabha Atomic Research Center in Mumbai. The topic for the national level essay competition for college students was the role of nuclear power generation in India's development. I won the prize for this competition. Having bagged these prizes at the state and national level competitions, the superiors of Don Bosco congregation suggested to me post-graduation in journalism. And therefore, I wrote the entrance examination and got admission in Kerala University campus and also in Calicut University campus, and opted for my MCJ program in Calicut University Journalism Department. After joining the department, I realized that there has to be a drastic change in my style of writing. Till I joined the Department of Journalism, I was an essayist but had no skill of a journalist. So there is a big difference between a traditional writer and a journalist. And this is the focus of my session for you today. What's the difference between an ordinary traditional writer and a journalist? All of you must have served as a secretary in some of the organizations. Could be the secretary of SFI, could be secretary of KSU, could be the secretary of ABBP. Or in terms of religion, you would have served as a secretary of KCYU or NSS. If you make a study or assessment about what is normally done by a secretary serving an organization or any kind of a venture, a report has to be presented before the participants whenever a meeting is held. And what is the strategy being followed by a secretary while presenting the report? The reporter, the secretary, always goes a very chronological format. What's a chronological format? The meeting began with a silent prayer. The meeting began with a prayer song. It was followed by a welcome address. Then the president spoke. So you have the normal procedures followed in a meeting reported as a secretary working in any organization. And you will have to wait for the end of the report for everyone to know what exactly were the decisions taken during the meeting. This is the traditional pattern of writing. This is the style of a historian. This is the style of a secretary of an organization. But the style of a journalist is totally different. And therefore, when I began writing, doing assignments as a student in the Department of Journalism in Calicut University, all my assignments were rejected because all my assignments were essayistic. It did not have the power, it did not have the punch to attract the attention of the readers. In a traditional format, the listener, the reader needs to have patience to understand, to read, to know the key points being driven home in the writing. In the case of a reporter working in a newspaper, working in a television channel, working in a magazine, or in a web portal, the style of writing is totally different. It is not written in the chronological format, as it happened from the beginning till the end. In journalism, we know every item that is part of a newscast, in the case of a television, or every item in a newspaper could be categorized into two: hard news and soft news. The hard news that we normally read in the newspapers follows inverted pyramid format. You know what is an inverted pyramid format is. In inverted pyramid format, the most important information is placed on top. All the pieces of information to be communicated to the readers, to be disseminated to the viewers, are arranged in the declining or descending order of importance. And therefore, the most important piece of information is in the opening paragraph. The least important piece of information is in the last paragraph of the story. And therefore, if you go for a diagram, the diagram will look like an inverted pyramid. How did this inverted pyramid emerge? Historical circumstances brought about a gradual evolution of this particular structure of inverted pyramid in journalism across the world. The history of inverted pyramid structure can be traced back to the American Civil War. From 1861 to 1865. You go back to those years. There was no television, there was no radio, and therefore the only way for people to communicate in from distant places was through telegrams. And during the American Civil War, the journalists, the reporters who went to report whatever was happening at the war front, in the battlefield, had the problem, technical problem, because while sending the telegram, while disseminating information through the telegraph lines, there could be disruption. The connection could be cut at any moment. And therefore, the traditional format of following the chronological style, what would happen to the information that the person, the reporter, wants to convey to the newspaper sub-editor or the news editor, while the key pieces of information are being given, the connection could be lost. And therefore, the ideal, the most effective method for a person sending a telegram from a distant place was to use inverted pyramid structure, in which the most important pieces of information are given at the beginning itself. And therefore, the technical failures or the disruptions in between will not affect the information dissemination. Though this particular format emerged because of historical circumstances, gradually journalists across the world realized that this was the best method of passing information to the readers. How did it become the most preferred format? Because from the perspective of the readers and also from the perspective of the sub-editors, this is the best method of giving information. From the perspective of the readers, for a busy reader, a news item written in the traditional conventional format, in the secretarial format, in the chronological format, reading a news item will be an organized waste of time, because the person has to search for the information that is hidden somewhere there. But in the case of a story that is crafted in inverted pyramid structure, it is saving time for the reader, because the reader will be captured by the headline. The headline will carry the crux of the story. The key piece of information is inside the headline. If I am interested in that particular news item, I will go beyond the headline to the intro. The opening paragraph. The opening paragraph in inverted pyramid format carries the summary of the story. The opening paragraph, the intro or the lead of the story, is an expansion of the headline. So a reader starts off with the headline, from the headline goes to the intro, and if the person does not have time, he will stop with this and he can go or switch over to another story. If the person is interested in knowing more about whatever is reported in that story, go to the second paragraph. The second most important pieces of information are lying inside the second paragraph. And the last paragraph of that particular story will carry the most unimportant or the least important piece of information. And therefore, a reader's time is saved with the inverted pyramid format. And therefore, it is a preferred format taking into consideration the requirements of the target audience. From another perspective, from the perspective of those who are in journalism field, working as reporters and as sub-editors in a news organization, inverted pyramid structure is the best method for writing. Because the reporters who report an event, an issue, or a phenomenon will logically arrange information in a fixed format, taking into account the requirements of the target audience. And after having crafted the story, the story is passed on to the news editor, and the news editor will forward the story for editing to the sub-editors. And what will the sub-editor do? Sub-editor will read the story and will verify the availability of space inside the newspaper in the allotted page by the news editor. Will the space given by the news editor be sufficient for the story to be placed there? In some cases, the length of the story is beyond what can be accommodated in the given space, and what is the responsibility of the sub-editor. The sub-editor is now going to cut the least important pieces of information in the story, and you are facilitating the sub-editor to save his time by deleting the last paragraph, because the last paragraph carries the least important piece of information. And therefore, it is a help also to the sub-editors working in a news organization when the stories are crafted in inverted pyramid format. And that is the reason why journalists working across the world craft all the hard news items in inverted pyramid format to help both the readers and also those who are doing the job of subbing in a news organization, the job of a sub-editor. And therefore, this is the way that we need to think about journalism, journalistic writing. There has to be a paradigm shift from the traditional mindset when you emerge as a journalist. And this transformation took place while I was a student at university campus in Calicut, when I switched over from the style of an essayist to the style of a journalist.